The remote vastness of America's Southwest deserts holds a plethora of life. Hidden among the canopy of cedar, they thrive in the world's harshest environments. Searching their haunt, for 11 years I have waited for my prey. My quest to thrust my spear into the lungs of a wild aoudad have left me alone in the desert. Again I wait, spear in hand. And again, they have come my way. Like before, they stop just shy of the bait, with eyes locked and ears forward, seemingly hypnotized. I'm spear hunting African aoudad. It's pretty rough, but I'm sure glad you could join me. A big billy has arrived. He too is lured by the bait. And then, he knows. He must. How they know, I will never know. Surely they must have a sixth sense. Years before, I wait in my stand as I watch him from above. He stares and listens, picking the forest apart. I have baited him for weeks, and trail cams show that he has come my way. This time a young billy has arrived, and I will be thrilled if I can kill him. I hold my ground and wait patiently. But patience pays no dividends with aoudad. And time passes until finally, he turns and leaves. Again, an aoudad is destined to take the bait. But drifts off, somehow knowing. They have tested my will, and now I question my own sanity. Again, I am back. I watch a young fawn below me feed. Whitetails are fools compared to aoudad. Behind me, a large band of ewes have shown up, with young billies at their side. Soaked by the pouring rain, they stand staring as always. Saturated from head to toe. I'm hoping that maybe, just maybe, I'm not giving off bad vibes. And the band of aoudad seemed to be calm this time. Has the rain changed the game? Time will tell. Now a big billy takes up the rear. And my pulse quickens with his arrival. Though the memory of failed hunts is fresh in my mind, a driving rain brings me hope. To my disbelief, the billy is now coming my way. I try not to look at his horns, but forget that. He is big. And as he nears my hide, for a moment, I thought he had me. I've never had one so close, and my heart races as I move slow. The huge ram is now in the bait. The problem is, he's directly under my stand. I wait for him to move out where I can get a throw, hoping that they don't sense my presence. Finally, he has stepped out where I can make the throw.
I'm soaking wet, but I don't care. He's right over there. Dead in those trees right over there. That spear. When I raised my spear, I said to myself, if ever you were going to make a perfect throw, let it be now. I said, Lord, direct this spear into the mark. Slog! I have speared a giant oddhead. A giant, a magnificent beast. Yes! Oh my gosh. Oh my. Yes! I have slocked Big Louie. Let's go look at him, Martin. Holy crap.
Look at that big beast.
Look how blonde he is.
Oh, he is something special. Man, he's all muddy and dirty. He's been rolling around in the mud, doing whatever he's doing. He's got beautiful curls. They come way back. Look at here. Look where the spear came out.
I mean, huge gash. I can't believe you came this far.
Yeah.
Look at that hole.
One lung and maybe touch the heart or the pumper veins and stuff, but man, anybody tells you a spear is not an effective killing tool.
I mean, what do you run, maybe?
70.
Yeah, 80 yards at the most.
Oh man, freaking amazing. Woo! I have speared an aoudad. Freaking aoudad, dude.
Yeah, it hadn't been easy
either. Crazy, man. I don't believe it. There was a big herd of them, Martin. And the first one in was the giant. The king daddy, Big Louie of the bunch.
He just came right in, huh?
He came in first. I was so shocked I hadn't had my cameras on yet. And when I suddenly see he come running in, I'm like, oh crap, gotta get my cameras on. Get them on. And then he goes, he's directly under my, he's so close, he's under my stand. I'm like, I can't spear him. This is horrible. And then he walked out the other side and I leaned over and I'm like, oh my gosh, whop! And I hammered him. Woo!
That's great. I mean, that's awesome.
We got a huge long day or evening ahead of us getting him out of here. We better get started.
All right, man. Congratulations.
All right. Thank you, brother.
Yes, sir.
All right, you're watching Relentless Pursuit. If someone else airs a spear kill tonight, I'll be surprised, because I got a feeling we might be the first ones ever, buddy. Yep. All right, let's start. Let's get the knives, get the cold steels, and let's get to work.
This is just one lobe of the lung. It got the other one also, but it went through the top side of the lobe. Probably the best damage I've seen to an organ, and that's from a spear, so the people that think they don't work very well, this can prove them wrong right here, because you put a hole like that through them, they can't make it.